Those pushing for the human resource bill believe the absence of a regulatory body to enforce the required professional standards has left many organizations operating unprofessionally.
So feel that we should not miss out when there is an opportunity, because you might find that not everybody has the same skills as far as, or qualifications as far as the human resource officers are concerned. We know that there are some people who qualified as lawyers. They have never gone for a course concerning human resource. We have others, could be a teacher, and the parents think that that's the best person to become a human resource. So they fail at times to handle the basics of what they should do. And so we feel that it's important to have a regulation.
So we don't expect any resistance. So after tabling it, we expect the committee to process it very fast, and we will not have a hurdle, any challenge in processing it. We expect positive support.
Last week, Workers MP Margaret Rwabashaija was granted leave of parliament to process the Human Resource Managers Professional Bill 2023, whose intention seeks to streamline conduct and professionalism in the human resources fraternity.
Unionists, we have been always aligned up by that if you want to talk to a human resource officer, they just bring anybody and just put him in front of you, that you talk to this one is the human resource officer. And sometimes he's not a professional human officer. So I think this was a right time, Honorable Margaret Rwabashaija, to bring a legislation in parliament. And we process it, and this profession should be regulated.
It can only be as good as its people, as its human capital. For the longest time, our human capital has been left to people who aren't really professionals, yeah? So we're excited that this is coming up at this point in time, that a legal and strong framework is going to be set up to govern the management of the country's strongest resources.
The bill seeks to establish a council and an institute to regulate the sector and handle disputes arising from human resources personnel and institutions they manage.
The outcomes of this effort will be the creation of a council, the HR Management Council. And this HR council will be responsible for setting the tone in the country, not only the tone for HR professionals, but also for consultants. There are so many people who call themselves human resource consultants who have given advice that may not have been the best advice to give organizations.
They believe it will help to mitigate case backlog in the industrial court, which arise from unprofessional conduct of HR managers. Ronald Bosa, the president of the Human Resource Managers Association of Uganda, says the industrial court is stuck with over 3,000 cases which arise from unfair termination of workers.
When you do a dipstick analysis of what is in there, most of them are either issues of unfair termination or unfair dismissal, and also issues of failure to honor the terms in the engagement letters. Sometimes you wonder who does these engagement letters. The engagement letters that are given to different people for work, whether written or unwritten. So the terms of engagement is always an issue, and the issue of termination and dismissal.
If you're a consultant and you want to keep your name, you want to keep your business, you must adhere to the registration as it is.
So report by Fred Kajubi for the news.